Hi everybody, Six Dream Brain Fingers here with a lesson for beautiful girls, Van Halen, off Van Halen 2. Thanks for watching, see you later. Just a little bit, then you go to two middle strings, second fret, part of the A chord, but don't play the open A. So you go, and second fret E, back to the two middle strings A, and then third fret E. So it goes. Then the next thing you do is 5th fret A, 4th fret D, this little chord up here with your pinky and the other finger. Then pull off that 5th fret A to 2nd fret A. And I've seen a lot of guys do it this way, which is much easier. It's the same chord, but you're holding it with these two fingers. And you slam down to the 7th fret E. And I was considering doing it that way too, because I can't do it the other way very well, but... And the next thing is the three power chords, but you put the open A muted between them, with a swing feel to it, so... And you repeat. Then the band kicks in, and you do it again. And this time you go... Two of them in there. Instead of just... Then those three power chords again, that little slippery lick after them. That's a full step bend on the 9th fret G string. Return to 9th. Then with the bar. So slowly. I tend to squeal that a lot more than he does just because it's fun. You gotta go back into open A, power chord D, 1 fret down, and then 2 frets down here. 3 power chords, funky like that. Then you kind of crank the volume knob down a little bit for the next part as you're holding that chord, and then you kind of roll off, you know. String, first one, second fret, both strings. Next chord, keep your finger here, second fret D and fourth fret A. So first one, second one. Keep it all funky. Third one, fourth fret A, I mean fifth fret A, fourth fret D. And that one you go, give it a sh. So, all three. Off from that 5th fret A to open A in a funky way. Next thing you do is back to that 2nd chord again, which was 2nd fret D, 4th fret A. 4, 2, 0 on the A, and you kind of hold part of that the D note there too, the D string 2nd fret on the 1st chord. And you can either pull it off like that or you can pick it. He does it alternate back and forth, however funky you happen to be feeling at the time. Open E. So that's the progression. Again. This time you go pull off again from 5th fret to open, 3rd fret A to 4th fret A, slide, so, 2 top strings open, and I do it with an upstroke. Try to keep everything quiet and make those real snappy, happy, dappy, crappy. Okay, then after that lick, next time around you go. Everything's the same except for the lick is not. It's 3rd fret A to 4th fret A, slide. 2nd fret D. Back to 4th fret A. And then E. Funky. But don't do that. Then get yourself out of the verse into that next heavy part, and that's where you can crank the volume back up, and you do it like kind of like this. As you're holding it last, crank the volume up while you're shaking it, and you kind of grab the slide up at the same time. Stay in that part. That's 3-2-0 on the A, all pull-offs, and then 3 on the E. Between the A chord and 2nd fret E. Kind of weird, because normally you gotta reach back for that one, you know. And then you do the same thing again, but you're up 2 sets of strings, 3-2-0 on the D, and then 3 on the A. And then this chord, 2nd fret power chord. Chorus is coming up, but first he goes back into the verse shortly. Power chords, partial power chords. It's between the 2nd, 4th, and 5th fret across, just bar across the D and the A string. 2, 4, 5. So, you do the same thing, but one set of strings up, bar across the D and the G string. 2, 4, 5. So. Slide to the 7th on the 2 middle strings. And back to the other part. C maybe? 3rd fret power chord. And then I know he does the next power chord up here. He goes. That crazy lick that he does next, I like to do that power, I like to do the D here instead of here. I go. He goes. I like to have this so I can let go and it still keeps ringing while it's set up for that crazy lick that's coming up. So the whole chorus again. Yeah. chorus to go back into the next verse, that crazy off the wall, way outside the box fill that he does. That's the craziest thing I ever heard. It goes 5-7-9 on the B. Pick the first two, hammer on the last one. And throughout this whole fill, he keeps the swing feel going too, which is just crazy. After, pull back off to 5. So. Then to 0. Okay, I'll add the next little part to that. That is 7-8-9 hammer-ons on the G string. Pull off to 5 on the G. Then to 0 on the G. So the whole thing's slow so far. Then the same exact thing, but on the D string. Before you were here. Now you're here. Then you go 7-5 pull off on the A. Slide down to the second fret. Kind of in one fluid. Then finish it up with 19th fret B and D twice, then pull off one fret, still B and E string, then do it again, then slide down one fret B and D. So the whole thing ridiculously slow. Is pretty much the same as the first one, except there's a couple of different fills in it. Okay, the first one, you slide up the high E and let off to open, and then you slide down the low E and let off to open. Then you go 3rd fret E string with a little bit of a quarter step bend, and then 2nd fret D. Then you go, I kind of rake across without, and end up on the 3rd fret B. And that's what you dive bomb that. Kind of like that. So where that ends up in the verse is here. Right there. On the A string, slide from 3 to 4. And keep it held down in 2nd fret D. And then open G. And you can kind of hear the echo in time when he stops. And keep it crappy happy. Happy.